years, y'all. Four years. Wow. Hello for the roughly 2700th time. I'm Trace, and you are all incredible humans. 4 years ago, on December 5th of 2012, we started DNews, and my first video that day was about the robot takeover. Let's do an update, shall we? Over the last 4 years, there have been a lot of advances in robotics, but the scariest and most amazing robot is Atlas. Yeah, that's Atlas, Boston Dynamics' awesome humanoid robot. It was first introduced in mid-2013 in a partnership with DARPA. At the time, it was loud, clunky, and it dragged around a massive tether. But now in 2016, oh crap, we're screwed. In 2016, it was announced that Atlas can walk outside without a tether, with sensors in its body and legs to balance, and LiDAR and stereo sensors, with the goal of, quote, making robots that have mobility, dexterity, perception, and intelligence comparable to humans and animals, or perhaps exceeding them. This robot is a step along the way. Damn it, damn it, damn it. The legs of Atlas are 3D printed to include arterial fluid routing, which is just creepy. And in case Atlas isn't freaking you out, the US Navy and Virginia Tech have created the Shipboard Autonomous Fighting Robot, or Saffir, which also has two arms and two legs, and it can walk on a ship. Can you even walk on a ship? Especially one that's on fire? Guess what, it's 2016 and robots can. But don't show your fear, because soon robots could use your emotions to manipulate your meat brain into trusting them. In a conference paper by researchers from Mississippi State University, they explored how people could sense emotions from a robot named Mary. The robot displayed anger, calm, fear, happiness, and sadness, with success rates as high as about 70% for calm and as low as 18% for happiness. Apparently, the humans weren't that awesome at guessing their displayed emotions yet. But a separate, more successful emotional robot is being tested with children in the Boston area. The robot is talking with kids as they learn Spanish by reading their emotional cues and responding as if the robot were a fellow child. If the kid needs help, the robot creates a motivational strategy based on their emotional state. Wow, creepy. But if robots can learn emotions, those emotions could help them override their own programming. For example, a Raytheon scientist named James Crowder invented robots that were taught to avoid light, but they also run on solar power. This is a pretty serious conflict. He told the Washington Post that even though they've been programmed to think that light hurts them, they have to balance the instincts of light still hurts, but if I don't find light, I'll die. All of these implications over the past 4 years are pretty interesting. Robots are learning to read and respond to our emotions and keep some for their own. And they're now walking outside in the sunshine and they can defy their own programming. But robots are still a long way off from a full-blown takeover. In 2012, I quoted Sir Martin Rees of the Center for the Study of Existential Risk at Cambridge, and he said that we'd have about a 50-50 chance of wiping ourselves out before 2100, with others believing robots would be one of those things. But then in 2015, he said, robots can't tie your shoelaces or cut your toenails, but they're getting better. He admits that they'll probably take some routine jobs and not just manufacturing ones, even in medical and legal professions. He goes on to say it's, quote, likely that during this century, our society and its economy will be transformed by autonomous robots, even though the jury's out on whether they'll be idiot savants or display superhuman capabilities. Look, it's inevitable that robots will eventually become intelligent and perform better at some tasks than we humans, but whether we will start a war for the planet, that's still up in the air. In reality, maybe we'll transform our economy and none of us will ever need to or really be able to work again. Or perhaps robots will begin to colonize space for us while we are stuck here on Earth thanks to radiation. It's hard to know, but with the advances in the last 4 years, it's gonna be a pretty wild ride for the next four. Some of you have been with us at DNews since the beginning. Thank you. Some of you joined today. Thank you. Seriously, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for supporting us over these last 4 years. 2017 is gonna be big. So this was an update to one of the very first videos I did for DNews. It aired on the very first day of DNews, December 5th of 2012. Watch it here, and let us know down in the comments what you thought of this video, and subscribe so you get more DNews.